Kill the zombies. Kill the zombies.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the laboratory. I have an update here on the sniper, and I also want to answer a couple of questions I got about the salting method. I have a few other videos in the archives that are there and that deal with the steps or a little clinic, so you might want to check them out. But again, I just want to show you what I start with is just salt three or four different varieties of salt, kosher, table. You know, I even put in a little bit of baking soda, okay, just to make it nice and, see, you could see it on my finger, different, you know, different grades, and that's important because you want to, once you get it back on the body like this, you want to have a variety of sizes stuck on there. And as you can see, it's spread all over, and you're gonna see the transformation once again. This is a very special time for me when I'm doing a build because, like most people, when they see this, they think, "Oh my God, what have I done?" You know, and what happens is that it's like magic. You know, I keep saying using that word in part because it is. You cover up the vehicle like this, and you think this is gonna be one giant mess, and you'll see it. The beauty of this is that you can, in fact, layer in the process as many times as you want, and I'm going to do it on the chassis. The other thing that you need with the salt, of course, is a one of these water misters, and so you just cover the part, and you sprinkle the salt on there. I mean, usually I say sparingly, but as you can see, I didn't take my own medicine there, in part because I want this one to really look damaged, like it's one of those vehicles that's gotten a lot of has gotten into a lot of skirmishes, and so we'll see. You know, a lot of people think, well, that's an easy excuse that the vehicle has gotten into a lot of battles, and that's why it's all pockmarked and riddled with all kinds of rust spots and stuff like that. And it's like, yeah, right, that's the idea. But you could do this really sparingly. Let's say you were working on a beater or a junker, you could use just a little pinch here and there, and then also you could use a liquid mask. Let me show you what else I've got over here. That's the chassis, which is gonna really get a beating. I'm working on the I've been painting a little bit more rust on the wonderful 55-gallon drums that Supercar Garage, aka Efren, sent me, which I'm in love with those things. This is the workhorse, the Iwata Eclipse small cup that I use, although I have a regular one as well. This is the liquid mask that I use. I'm not using it on this build yet, and I don't know if I will, but this is fabulous stuff, and a little jar will go a long way. So you can have a lot of fun with this. There are certain parts that I have in primer, and then in rust coat that I haven't painted yet, added the salt to, because I'm waiting to see how the colors that I'm planning to use turn out. So anyway, that's just a brief update of where we are. Later today, I should have it in paint, and we'll see where it goes from there. After that, you know the routine: washes, detailing, adding powders, and all of that other good stuff. So stay tuned in for more. And remember, the place where you come to get your styrene addiction, there it is, Dr. Cranky's Laboratory. So stay tuned in and have a great day, folks. We'll see you back.